Hello, good morning everyone. Today we will discuss about high torque rotors. So what do you mean by the high torque rotor? Okay, so in induction motor, in induction rotor. So induction motor, it is divided into two types. One is squirrel cage rotor. And another one is slip ring rotor. So how to increase the torque? Okay, so the torque can be increased, that is directly proportional to the resistance of the rotor. Okay, so if the resistance is very high, so then torque is going to be increased. Okay, so to increase the torque, the resistance of the particular motor is going to be increased. So in induction motor, in slip ring rotor, so what happened? So in slip ring rotor, the slip ring rotor windings are connected to the three phase rheostat during starting, right? So these are the slip rings. So like this, so we can connect rotor winding of slip ring induction motor. This is the rotor. So similarly, a stator part is there. Stator is also having the stator, and rotor can be connected to the rheostat, right? So we can vary the rheostat. So during the starting, so at the time of running, the rheostat will be disconnected. Okay, rotor will running under the normal condition. Okay, so we can vary the rheostat. We can vary the resistance of the rotor by inserting the some external resistance to the circuit. So if we can increase the resistance of the rotor, automatically your torque is going to be increased. Okay, so you already seen these things in slip ring rotor. Okay, so slip ring induction motor, so this type having high starting torque. Why it is high starting torque? Because it has a high resistance during starting. Okay, so what about squirrel cage rotor? So squirrel cage rotor, we cannot connect any external resistance to the squirrel cage rotor, right? Because the windings are embedded like this, the totally short circuited windings are there in squirrel cage type of rotor. Okay, we cannot connect, so there is no slip rings and brushes are provided on the squirrel cage type of rotor. So how to increase the torque of the squirrel cage rotor? That is the question here. How to increase the torque of the squirrel cage rotor? So for that purpose, so there are divided into two different kinds of rotor in squirrel cage rotor. One is called as deep bar rotor, another one is double cage rotor. Okay, squirrel cage rotor can be divided into two types: deep bar rotor, another one is double cage rotor. So by using these two type of rotor, you can modify the construction of the squirrel cage rotor. So the cage of the winding or bar of the winding, that can be having a different construction to increase the resistance of the squirrel cage rotor. Okay, you cannot connect external rheostat here. You cannot connect external rheostat to the deep bar rotor. Okay, so you can easily connect to the slip ring rotor, but it is not possible for the squirrel cage rotor. Okay, for that purpose, they are divided into two types. So that is deep bar rotor, another one is double cage rotor. So these are called as the high torque rotor. So that is used in the squirrel cage rotor. Okay, so So in deep bar rota, so what is deep bar rota? So how we can increase the resistance of the rotor? So how if the resistance increases, so how exactly the torque that is going to be increases? Okay, so what happened? So the deep bar rotor, suppose this is the rotor, so these are the bars. These are the bars of the construction. So the area of this bar, okay, so this area of this bar, so we can construct in depth. So the current, how the current is flowing in this area of the conductor, so this is the bar. The current does not flow inside, so it will flow in the surface of the conductor, the external surface of the conductor, the current is flowing, okay, in case of AC. So this is called as skin effect. Suppose this is the conductor is like this. Okay, the current will be flowing in the external surface in this part, not in middle part. Okay, so this effect is called as skin effect. So this entire area, it cannot be used, so it will be used only the external surface of the conductor. So this is called as the skin effect. So this will increases the, it will reduce the total area. So what is the resistance? Rho L by A, the total area is decreases, the resistance is going to be increases. Okay, so therefore, so that technique is used in the deep bar rotor. So in the deep bar rotor, it consists of deep bar rotor. This is the deep bar rotor construction. So it has upper cage as well as lower cage. Okay, upper cage and lower cage. So similar to this, so the conductors are provided like this. So around this, a magnetic fluxes are created. The leakage reactance of this, so the leakage reactance of upper and leakage reactance of lower cages, so that can be defined as upper cage reactance is less than the lower cage reactance. Okay, so here what happens, your current will be flowing like this. So at the time of starting, the current is higher, the torque is higher, the resistance is higher, and current will be lower. So at the time of running, that is called a normal speed. The distribution of current. I will show here. So high torque rotors. So I already explained about the slip ring induction motor. It has an external resistance, right? So it can be added in the rotor circuit during the starting, which gives the high starting torque. and lower starting line current that can be improved by the power factor. And the squirrel cage induction motor, there is no provision made for adding the external resistor. So that's why we are going for deep bar rotor, and another one is double cage rotor. So the high starting torque can be obtained by the use of, that is, deep bar rotor and double cage rotor. In both these, so what happened? The types of rotor makes use of skin effect. I have explained what is skin effect. So skin effect means the external part of the surface of the area, the current will be flowing. So the distribution of the current is not uniform, but alternating current has a tendency to concentrate near the surface of the conductor, not in middle, on the surface of the conductor. Due to this effect, effective area of the cross section of the conductor is reduced. So therefore, the resistance of conductor is going to be increases. If resistance is increases, torque is also going to be increases. At the time of starting, what happened? What is the slip? Slip is equal to 1 at the time of starting. So what is the frequency? Frequency is equal to S into F. Okay, the frequency of the rotor current. So slip is 1. So for example, frequency is 50 Hertz. So your frequency of the rotor is also 50 Hertz. So your frequency of the rotor is very much higher. So it will use the high starting torque. Because if frequency is higher, your reactance will be less. Okay. So therefore, the rotor consists of deep bar rotor and short circuit by the two end rings. So on each side. Okay. So this is the construction of the deep bar rotor. In the deep bar rotor has a deep and narrow rotor bars. So these are the deep. So here to here. Okay. So one slot we have shown here. So like that, there are several number of slots are around the total, around the periphery of the rotor. Okay. And it may be a rectangular cross section, that is shown in the figure. So magnetic leakage flux, that lines are shown, that is called as a dotted line. So this is called as magnetic leakage flux. Leakage flux lines, that is shown by the dotted line. So the leakage inductance at the bottom strip, that is greater than that of top strip. Okay, so lower cage. So this is the higher cage. So XL here. XL and XL. So that is the leakage reactance in the both the case. So in the top leakage reactance, the leakage reactance of the bottom is greater. Okay, XL upper, XL lower. So therefore, XL upper is less than XL lower. Okay, so our bottom leakage reactance is more compared to the upper leakage reactor. Okay, so what happens, the greater than the top strip, so all the strips are in parallel electrically. The current in the top strip is greater than the top lower strip. Okay, so what happens, so leakage reactance, so current is opposite to the reactors, 1 by X. Okay, the reactance is lesser, current will be higher. So in bottom side, the reactance is less. So reactance is less. Sorry, reactance is more. So current will be very less. In top side, the reactance is less. So current will be more. Okay. So according to this, so what happens? So thus, there is a non-uniform distribution of current, so which is shown in the figure 2. So this is the non-uniform of distribution of current. So XL, here XL is higher, so current will be, XL is higher, current will be very low. So current is very low, low current, because X is, reactance is high. So in this case, so XL is lower, so current will be very high. At the time of starting, we will get very high current. So because of that, high starting torque will be achieved. So due to the non-uniform distribution of current and skin effect, the effective area of cross section it is going to be decreases, hence rotor resistance is increasing. Okay, by varying this, so rotor resistance is going to be increasing due to the variation of the leakage reactances. Okay, so therefore we will get the high starting torque. So coming to the figure number 2 here, so it is the ratio of AC effective resistance to the DC effective resistance. So this is the resistance ratio. Okay, so how it will be increased with respect to the frequency. So frequency is higher, so the ratio is also going to be higher. Okay, so we will get at the time of starting, so we have 50 hertz. So rotor frequency, what happened, S into F, slip is 1, so into 50, we will get 50 hertz at the time of starting. At the time of starting, so we will get nearly 50 hertz. So this is the ratio of effective resistance, AC to DC effective resistance. Okay, so it is going to be decreased under normal running condition. Now under starting condition it is very high, under running condition it will be decreases. Okay, if the frequency is increases, so your ratio is also going to be increases. So what happened to the resistance? If the resistance is increases, so high rotor resistance will get higher torque. Okay, so if the resistance will be low, so your torque is also going to be reducing. Okay, and if the deep bar rotor resistance is up to this much, you will get the torque up to here. So if you further, if you want to increase the resistance, your torque is also going to be increases with respect to the slip. This is the torque slip characteristic. And deep bar rotors has low starting torque, so compared to the double cage rotor. So with high starting torque or without affecting the running performance of the motor. With high starting torque, low starting current and high starting torque. So initially starting torque is also higher, but current will be lower. So without affecting the running performance of the motor, the net reactance of the deep bar rotor at standstill is higher than the normal bar design. So therefore the breakdown or pull out torque in deep bar rotor is very much lower. So this is about the deep bar rotor. Okay, similar to the next one, next concept is called as double cage rotor. So some modification is there here. So instead of deep bar, so in deep bar what happened, only a single cage, a depth of the cross section is there. Okay, so this is called as deep bar rotor. Deep bar rotor. So this is called as double cage rotor. Double cage means individual windings are there. Okay, this is the one cage, this is the another cage. So make it as a upper cage and a lower cage. Okay, similar to the deep bar only. So this modification is there. So this is the rotor one, and in both the case the leakage reactance will be different. This leakage reactance produce. Okay, so generally lower cage leakage reactance XL is higher. In upper cage XL is lower. So because a small leakage reactance is there here, so here the leakage reactance is more. Same concept it will be applied here in double cage rotor also. The rotor consists of two cages, two layers of bar that is short circuited by the both end called as the end ring. In upper cage it is having a smaller cross section and area, smaller cross section area than the lower cage, and upper cage is having a high resistance than the top lower cage. Okay, so upper cage having a higher resistance and than the lower cage. Okay, so upper cage is made up of high resistance material. Okay, like brass and aluminium will be used here as a conductor for the upper cage to increase the resistance of the winding. So similarly for lower cage, it is made up of low resistance material like copper. So copper material is used in the lower cage. In higher in top cage, so they are using like aluminium, brass, okay, etc. These type of material is used. So to increase the resistance. Resistance is increases, here resistance is decreasing. So what happened to the double cage rotor? Look to the characteristics. The upper cage and lower cage are separated by a normal slit that is called as constriction. Constriction. So it is divided by two. So this is called as constriction. Constriction. The air constriction generally it may be used. So that is, it will separate the both the winding or both the cages, that is called as a constriction. So what happens now? Torque due to upper cage, this is the torque due to upper cage, and torque due to inner cage, so this is the lower cage. So torque obtained by the lower cage and torque obtained by the higher cage, the summation of these two, this will give the resultant torque. The resultant torque of the rotor. Okay, how it is about slip and torque characteristic. At the time of starting, the torque will be like this because S is equal to 1. So, at the time of running, the slip is almost near to the 0 or 0.1. So, your torque will be decreasing. So, only at the time of starting, you will achieve the higher torque. At the time of running, the torque would be reduced. So rotor speed up, the rotor frequency decreases, which decreases the leakage reactance of the lower cage. So under normal operating speed, the reactance difference between the two cages is negligibly small. Hence, division of the rotor current in this case is mainly decided by the resistance of the two cages. Okay, so due to this, so double cage rotor, so it will achieve the high starting torque. So we will write the equivalent circuit of the double cage rotor. So like general induction motor, how you are writing R naught, X naught, and I naught. I naught is the no load current. This is divided into two part. So that is IW. Or IC, that is working component of current, and another one is I mu, magnetizing component of current. So IW is flowing in R naught, I mu is flowing in X naught. So this is called as total I naught. Okay, and I1 is the main primary current, that is the summation of I naught plus I2 R dash. Okay, so here I2 R dash is there. So I2 R dash means what? What is I2R? I2R is the rotor current. So what is I2R dash? This is also a rotor current, but referred to primary. Referred to primary side. Okay, while writing the equivalent circuit, so dash represent, it is referred to the opposite side. So that is called as the primary side. Therefore, we are representing, this is called as I2R dash. And R1 and X1, what is R1 and X1? These are the stator resistance. Refer to the stator part, resistance of stator and reactance of the stator winding. Similarly, so the rotor winding is divided into two parts. So one is upper cage, another one is lower cage. So this is for upper cage, this is for lower cage. In both the case, the upper cage reactance. So generally reactance and rotor resistance and reactance represented in terms of 2. R2 means rotor resistance, X2 means rotor reactance. Okay, so these are under standstill condition. So if represent 2R, so then it is called as for running condition. So here R2 and X2, so both are showing here. So that is X2 upper case, that is represented by X2U, dash represent, refer to the primary side, referred to the primary means that is the stator side. Referred to the primary means stator. Okay. So similarly, R2 dash of uppercase divided by S. This will give the load resistance of this. So what is the current flowing here? I2 dash into RU. So general current is I2R. So this is I2R dash. So I2R dash, it is summation of I2R U plus I2R, so another one is lower case, I2R L. So both will consider dash dash. Okay. So because all refer to the stator side. So therefore I2R dash is equal to I2R dash U plus I2R dash L. Okay. So and resistances are R to U by S and this is R to L by S. This is the equivalent circuit of the double cage rotor. So this is the approximate equivalent circuit of double cage rotor of induction motor that is shown here. Though the two cages are somewhat coupled magnetically, they can be treated as independent. Okay, for simplicity, it gives the approximate same result. The two cages are assumed to be parallel. So both are parallel. So therefore, the total equivalent circuit will be derived. So I2RU and I2RL dash can be represented by currents in the upper and lower cages referred to the stator side, because dash is there referred to the stator side. Similarly, R2 dash and R2 dash of upper and lower represent the resistance of upper cage and lower cage referred to the stator only. And X2U dash and X2L dash, leakage reactance of the two cages refer to the stator of the induction motor. So this is the equivalent circuit of the double cage rotor. So to perform, to get the performance evaluation of the double cage rotor. Okay, this is about this. So next class we will discuss about the induction generator. So what is induction generator and what is induction motor running as a induction generator. Okay. So is it clear? So whatever you have learned today, high torque rotors in that deep bar rotor and double cage rotor. So how to increase the torque of the rotor by increasing the resistance of the rotor. How resistance will be increasing? By changing the distribution of the current, because of leakage reactances are varied in the upper cage and lower cage. So distribution of current is varied. So due to this skin effect, the resistance of the total area is going to be varied. So therefore resistance will be high, the current will be low. So due to that, you will get maximum torque. When high resistance, that will give the higher torque. Okay. So this can be achieved in both deep bar and double cage rotor. Double cage rotor is somewhat different from the deep bar rotor. So instead of deep bar rotor, it is split into two parts, double cage, upper cage and lower cage, by separated by the constriction. Okay. And upper cage is made up of high resistance material and lower cage is made up of low resistance material like copper. Okay, and we will achieve the resultant torque by obtaining the summation of two torque, that is the upper cage and lower cage torque. We will get the total torque, that is called the resultant torque in case of double cage rotor. And also we have studied the equivalent circuit and performance and evaluation of double cage rotor. Is it clear? Hello. Any doubt regarding this?
No.
Okay. So, shall we stop here?